did you know that Iowa is the only state with 4 border rivers? Pretty cool, right? They are the Mississippi River, the Big Sioux River, the Des Moines River, and the Missouri River. The Mississippi River is the biggest of Iowa's border waterways, and since it starts way up in northern Minnesota and flows all the way down to the Gulf of Mexico, people figured out pretty early and pretty quickly that the Mississippi River was an awesome way to transport people and goods, especially before trains and trucks and airplanes were around. But relying on the flow of the river's current to transport people and goods from one place to another could take boats a long time. Plus, going downstream with the current was easy. Going upstream against the current could be impossible until the invention of the steamboat. Steamboats could travel much faster and push through the river's currents. Plus, they were built to navigate shallow areas in the river easier. As Iowa just entered statehood, steamboats traveled the Mississippi River to bring people, food, and equipment to our growing young communities. So Kirk, tell me, what years were steamboats the major mode of transportation in Iowa?
Well, early on, we're talking the 1830s, okay. 20s, up to the 50s and 60s through the Civil War.
Oh.
On up into around 1900.
And what sort of cargo was being carried on those steamboats?
Well, a lot of people.
Okay.
Well, it was the interstate highway of the day.
Oh,
a lot of people traveled by steamboat, and they come up the river systems. And so they would get to a certain state wherever the river hit that state.
Okay, and what was that boat ride like for them?
It was long.
Yeah,
it
pretty
was
slow moving.
Slow. And it was somewhat dangerous, they were steamboats. And they were wooden. They were made out of wood. You had the embers coming out of the smokestacks, going back to the back. Sometimes
oh, wow.
they'd land on the boat,
and
it would cause a fire.
Oh,
my
goodness.
It was somewhat an adventure.
And what about the water on the Mississippi? What was that like for travelers?
Most places it was, the river was much narrower up here at the time. There was a rapids between Keokuk and Montrose, 10 miles. Mm-hmm. And so the big boats couldn't get through the rapids. They had to stop in Keokuk, packet their goods 10 miles around to put it on a boat going north.
Uh-huh.
Or the northern boats had to do the opposite, put it on a boat going south.
Okay.
And so the travel was somewhat limited.
So why did we eventually stop using steamboats?
Well, cars came along.
Okay.
Around the turn of the century, cars started to become a mode of transportation. And because of that, roads were built.
Uh-huh.
People were able to travel within the states.
Sure, they weren't just limited to the river then.
Not so much on the boundaries. And so that started it.
Are there still steamboats on the Mississippi River?
For recreational purposes only. There are some steamboats that are used for dinner cruises and such as that in the big cities. But for the most part, the steamboats are gone.
Next time you see the mighty Mississippi River, imagine what a steamboat would have looked like chugging along way back then. Thanks for having fun investigating new discoveries in Iowa.
Funding for Find Iowa has been provided by the following supporters.